Okay, you know how I said we weren't coming back to the forest navel? I was lying. I want to show you something very important, guys. That thing I was saying about Pikmin Extinction, where if you get them all killed and the day automatically ends, you get a cutscene with that. So I just want to show it to you for the sake of seeing it. I've gone ahead and killed almost all of my Pikmin, walking the blues into fire, walking everyone else into water. I started the video here so you wouldn't have to listen to the agonized, dying screams of hundreds of Pikmin. You're welcome. How sad he is. It cuts me, it really does. Ten days since impact. The Pikmin have all perished because of my own carelessness. I am an utter disgrace as a leader. How can I continue to collect parts without them? Still, the onions join me in low orbit, as if this Pikmin extinction had never happened. I shan't sleep tonight. Oh, and who would? Don't save, very important. And when you go to land with your completely hopeless, empty onions... When the Pikmin become extinct, the onion releases a single seed. How does the onion know that the Pikmin have all been lost? I do not understand this mechanism, but I have no time to try to decipher its riddle. I must do all I can to protect the lone Pikmin. And, of course, I must prevent such an extinction from ever happening again. So, now you start over from scratch. You have one of each Pikmin. You may notice that the blue onion didn't drop a seed. That's because... It doesn't work when a Pikmin dies in water. If a Pikmin dies in water, it won't drop a seed. But if they die on land, then flower Pikmin leave seeds for you. Oh, a new hope. Okay, so that's the Pikmin extinction scene for you. I'm going to reset the game and eat some ice cream before I carry on with the walkthrough. Yeah.